You're broadcasting over WAAM, and this comes to you direct from the Edison Studios. WAAM, located at 1 Bond Street, Newark, operates on a frequency of 1120 kilocycles.
All of you are probably familiar with these sponsored radio programs, which are rapidly becoming the highest type entertainment features on broadcasting stations. The finished product, in a great majority of cases, is a most satisfactory program from the listener's viewpoint. However, few listeners perhaps realize the amount of time and effort that is spent in preparing the program so that it will be entertaining and instructive. Let us therefore take a peek into the workshop where these broadcasting units are conceived and put together. We will be unexpected guests, so we'll just make ourselves as inconspicuous as possible in order not to force company manners on our host. Be very quiet now. Here we are.
Hey, Gene, come here a minute, will you?
Sure, Jack. What's troubling our budding continuity writer this morning?
It's this candy account. I've got to rush through a sample program for them, and my brain is about as dry as the WCPU.
Candy account, huh? What could be sweeter?
Well, it may sound sweet to you, but it's been poison to me so far. I haven't enough time to give it anything but a lick and a promise, and I can't even start the lick.
Why, I never heard you talk that way before, Jack. What's wrong?
Oh, everything. I can't get started. I guess I'm getting stale or something.
Well, you certainly won't do much for a candy account if you're stale. However, it's probably better for the audience that it's you and not the candy that's suffering from this.
Oh, cut out the kidding, Gene, and give me a hand. This is serious.
Oh, I'll help you, all right. But you don't expect me to submerge my sunny disposition just to match your dark brown taste.
I should have known better than to even think you could forget your pitiful attempt at humor. But if you really put your mind on this job, I guess I can stand your wisecrack. Here, sit down over here so we can get going anyway.
All right. Give me a piece of paper. Now, let's see. We're going to sell candy. That ought to be easy. You can use all kinds of appeals there. There's romance, cleanliness.
Don't try to be scientific. We haven't time for any analysis. Just figure out what sort of talent to use so we will at least have made a start.
Gosh, you're touchy today. But if you won't let me do any figuring, at least tell me what you're going to push.
Candy.
Oh, I know, but what's their special? What do they call their big seller?
Well, that's just it. They haven't any. A little bit of everything.
Fine. There's your cue for the program. A little bit of everything. Dance music, love themes, old-timers, all kinds of stuff. Come on, old gloomface. Let's grab ourselves a flock of loose talent and have a rehearsal.
Rehearsal? Why, good grief, man. You don't even know what you're going to rehearse.
Well, never mind. You want my help, don't you?
Yes.
Well, then, shut up and come on. I'm like the organ grinder's monkey. I work better to music.
Well, this promises to be interesting, though I must confess that so far I have been rather surprised at the methods used. It hardly seems possible that we are seeing the assembling of a future program high spot. But I suppose Jack and Gene belong to that irrepressible younger generation which performs miracles while appearing to be occupied only with the thought to today's pleasures. We might as well see this thing through now that we've started. So let's follow them. There they go through that door marked B. Let's hurry. We don't want to miss anything.
Hey, whoa, wait a minute there, boys. Wait a minute. We're here to work, not play.
Why, they always work at their play, Jack.
Uh-huh. And if you'll wait a minute, I'll write out a lot more laughs so that you can put them in their proper places after your witty remarks. It'll save me a lot of time and effort.
For heaven's sake, Jack, take that chip off your shoulder. Oh, Harry, give us a nice lively number and see if we can pep this poor boy up a little.
Thank you.
won't do for an opener.
No, no. Now, Harry, here's what we want. A nice, soothing melody that's going to make folks' mouths water. And take it easy on the last chorus so that I can make the announcement. And after I finish reading, jump right into a real lively tune. Jack and I will write up something while you're playing. So you can start whenever you're ready.
Moana, where the tropic winds are blowing, someday I will be going to that sunny south beyond. Far off in Honolulu, in that land of daily sunshine, you'll find eternal springtime with Moana and her smile. When shades of night are falling, with shadows softly creeping, I know Moana's weeping in that sunny South Sea Isle. I've a love for sweet Moana, where tropic winds are blowing. Someday I will be going to that sunny South Sea Isle. Nestle off a sweet Moana, where the tropic winds are blowing. Someday I will be going to that sunny South Sea Isle. Far off in Honolulu, in that land of daily sunshine, you'll find eternal springtime with Moana and her smile. When shades of night are falling, with shadows softly creeping.
Ladies and gentlemen, we introduce tonight a new feature, A Little Bit of Everything, which will from now on be a regular part of our Friday evening program. The Williams Confectionery Company, manufacturers of distinctive candy, is taking this method of acquainting you with their new assortment, A Little Bit of Everything. Thank you.
How's that, Jack Goldstein?
Sounds all right, but this Williams company hasn't got any new assortment called A Little Bit of Everything.
Oh, I know they haven't, but I think it's good. And perhaps this sample program will sell the Williams crowd the idea of marketing one. At any rate, you asked my help and you're getting it. And after it's all done, you can take my poor efforts up to that boss of yours for his opinion. The trouble with you is you're scared stiff to try anything that isn't along the same old lines that have always been acceptable to the boss.
Yes, but
well, let's not talk about that now. What's the next thing? Say, George, suppose you step in now and give us a taste of sunny skies, soft breezes, murmuring trees, you know, a birch canoe, the girl you love, and a little bit of everything. We'll try to think of some name other than Sweet Williams or the Candy Kids.
I'm in love with you.
pretty, Gene, and I think that announcement just about fills the bill, too. Candy and romance are pretty close together.
Thanks, Jack, but this thing gets harder and harder every minute.
You said it. It's no easy job to take some products and fit it to music and write things to say between numbers and bring in the station announcement and everything so that when you're finished, you've got a nice program unit.
Oh, I know it isn't, but it's been done before, and we've got to do it right now. So let's not burden ourselves by crying out how hard it is.
Well, who started this crying business anyway? Besides, I never saw such a mess as you've got right now. Who ever heard of trying to write up a continuity the way you're doing? A lot of talent sitting around doing nothing?
All right. Let's make them work as long as they're here. Music is a good stimulant for some heavy thinking. Come on, Harry. Let's hear what else you've got.
Say, if this is going to be a little bit of everything, we'll have to get more variety than we've got now.
That's right. We ought to have some of the fair sex in here, too. Who's in this morning, do you know?
Well, we're using Janet in that midday feature. She ought to be around. I'll take a look and see who I can find.
Wait, before you go, how would a piano double do as a little bit of variety?
Fine. And maybe you could work in a banjo solo, too. I'll try to get a few more features and come back.
Go ahead, and while you're gone, I'll see what other combinations we can make out of this bunch we've got here. Oh, Harry, come here, will you?
What's that?
Oh, nothing's the matter. Just want your valuable assistance.
I'll be right with you.
Say, have you got any soloists in that outfit of yours?
Why, they're all soloists.
I thought you'd say that. What I mean is a real soloist.
Yes, and that's what I mean, too. And if you don't believe it, I'll prove it to you. Say, fellas.
Would sure make a mess of this box of candy. But each of your boys did his stuff okay. Can you give us a solo that's a little sweeter? Like Home Sweet Home. Something different is what I want.
Well, how about a sax quartet?
Fine, if you've got one. Let's hear it. Wait a minute, here's Jack. Got anything, Jack? Yes, Miss Janet Bushett and a few more on
it. Hey, how about that sax quartet?
Sure, go ahead while I see what Jack dug up.
Thank you.
good unit, Gene, but I don't like the selection.
Well, never mind about the selection. We can change that. Now, what have you got?
Well, where did you hear them? There's no use telling you about them. You'll want to hear them anyway.
Well, that suits me. While you're getting them started, I'll get back to some of these announcements.
Here's something a little different, Gene. Tell me how you like it.
Thank you.
Well, how do you like that voice? Fine. And for you alone's a favorite of mine, too. Let's have that piano double now. Say, Ernie, break out your two pianos, will you? Any of the keys, Ernie. Say, Jack, there's a lot of variety here, but I don't think it's going to be hard. Oh, it is going to be hard to jump right from the beautiful contralto solo into a red-hot piano to double.
Everybody's doing it. Besides, we're selling a little bit of everything in the way of candy. You have to give them a little bit of everything in the way of music, too.
Well, all right. Let's have the rest of your gang.
Sure, why don't you hear this?
All right, sugar, let's have it.
Everything is lovely, the world is so serene. When I say things are lovely, you know just what I mean. It means that I'll be happy, no more I'll have to care. Why I'm happy, oh so happy, not someone answers yes. Birds were singing merrily, and the sun was shining peacefully. Love my baby, don't be baby now. They when their preacher questions me, I'll answer yes or yes to me. Come my baby, don't be baby now. I just had a little letter yesterday. Now I feel a little better, so I'll say. Nine is yours, mighty sweet. Nine, oh, mine is quite sweet. Come my baby, don't be baby now. They birds were singing merrily, and the sun was shining peacefully. Come my baby, don't be baby now. And when that preacher questions me, I'll answer yes or yes or e. Come my baby, don't be baby now. I just had a little letter yesterday. Now I feel a little better, so I'll say.
Yeah.
little. Say, Gene, get these Hawaiians to do a popular number. So don't you think that'll be a good idea?
Okay. How about it, George?
Number, but don't you think we've got enough jazz, Jack?
Yes, I do, but the next group is by no means jazz.
Well, let's hear it then.
All right, go ahead, Bob.
Thank you.
do you think of that, Gene? Wait a minute. That won't do. That's terrible.
Well, what's terrible?
That wisecrack about the caramel on the dessert. Wow, that's awful.
Awful? Well, that's a play on words. Caramel, camel. Dessert, desert.
Play on words? That's roughhouse. Cut it out, Gene. I wouldn't let that pass.
Oh, just put it in there to see if you're awake or not.
Well, I'm awake all right and feeling better every minute, too. But say, what are we going to call the singer?
Oh, I don't know. The 3-2 tenor or something like that.
Oh, quit kidding, Gene. You can't call him that, and we've got to call him something. How about the Virginia Sugar Plum?
That's nice. Or Bonbon or Candy Pruitt or something like that. Why, there's lots of possibilities, Jack. Let's get him to sing a little more. Perhaps he'll give us an inspiration. Say, Walter, can you do a number for us?
Getting funny. You're not only planning a radio program, but you're designing a box of candy at the same time. What are you trying to put in there now, a gumdrop?
Yeah, no box of candy that's supposed to be a little bit of everything would be complete without a gumdrop.
Well, you'll have a fine time trying to hook up some musical selection with a gumdrop.
Is that so? Did you ever hear of Dr. Cook? Didn't he feed gumdrops to the Eskimos? And haven't the Eskimos got their own peculiar type of music?
Well, that's easy. All you gotta do is quit laughing. What's so funny about that? If this program ever goes over the air and the radio audience gets the kick out of it that I'm getting right now, your fortune's made, brother.
Well, I'll bet Harry can play some Eskimo music that I can work up into a lead for a gumdrop announcement.
Go ahead, Harry. Give us some nice music, nice chilly stuff about icebergs and northern lights and the midnight sun. Seems to me that sort of music would apply to a chocolate peppermint easier than to a gumdrop.
Are you satisfied? I told you you could spit something with your gumdrop. Iceberg?
Oh, boy. It's a cold number. It's not so hot, Steve. Listen, you're getting my help. Please give me room.
I'll give you room.
You must have been thinking about an ice cream cone instead of a gumdrop. Is that right? That's it. What cold ideas you got.
You chill me.
Shut the call music off. I'm getting a chill. You're
not so hot yourself.
Oh, this is gonna be good. I know. I can see this like a candy already. Snow all over the top of it. Is that what you mean?
I think we better leave that gumdrop out of the program. It's too hard to fit in.
But say, wait a minute. How about the station announcement?
Yeah, that's got to go in somewhere. Gosh, I hate to break up a perfectly good continuity by saying stand by for station announcement.
So do I. Someday they'll cut out that periodic announcement of the call letters. You just can't introduce it gracefully, and I don't see where it's so absolutely necessary.
Neither do I. But if it's got to go in, let's just bust right in with it after a musical selection without any standby.
Okay, mark down your 14-second wait on the timesheet. I'll have the boys play some more, and then I'll make an announcement just so you get it done. Hey, Harry, let's hear some late popular stuff. Who's that fellow you were just talking to, Jack? Who is it?
Disaster, that's who it is. I could wring his neck after all of this.
What's the matter? What's the matter?
It's all off.
All off? You mean this program?
Yes, been put off for 2 weeks.
Good night. Well, that's broadcasting. Why was it put off?
Yeah, the Williams people want to work up a new assortment and are holding up everything.
Jack, quick, tell that fellow it isn't off and tell him we want him to listen to this program right away. Make it tomorrow. Boy, what a break. I tell you, that little bit of everything is a good idea and with enough time can be worked up in great style. Beat it, Jack. Here's your chance to make a hit.
Hey, I think you're right, King. I'm sure obliged.
Hurry up, beat it, and don't stand here. Hey, boys, come over here a minute. Listen, you fellows don't mind working a little late, do you?
Oh.
Well, that's fine. We've got a chance to put over an idea, and we'll have to polish up a real program for tomorrow. Now step on it and run over some of your best numbers. I'll listen to them while Jack's out grabbing opportunity by the scuff of the neck. Afternoon at 2:30. You know, I really do think we can do something with that idea. Say, let's call the wives and tell them we won't be home to supper. The old pep's back again, and boy, you're some little gloom chaser. And contrary to all beliefs, the more I get of this candy, the better I feel.
Let the boys amuse themselves while we prepare to burn the midnight oil. Come on, Gene.
Well, that's that. It seems as though Jack and Gene were in for a long sitting. Personally, I'm very anxious to know just what sort of a program the boys will produce. But I suppose we'll have to wait until next week. I'll be here again Tuesday night, and if you all want to come with me, you're more than welcome. We'll meet at the same place, and then do a little more eavesdropping on Jack and Gene. I hope you have enjoyed yourselves. It's been a real pleasure to have you along, and well, until next week, then. Good night.
From September 11, 1928, that was A Little Bit of Everything, an audition program recorded by Thomas Edison Studios for WAAM Radio in Newark, New Jersey. Next week, we'll stay in Newark a little longer as we experience these fascinating treasures from the earliest days of radio. Join me then. I'm John Grimmett, and this has been Radio Journeys. Have a great week, everyone.
More footnotes next week, and so in friendly fashion, good luck